Welcome to Grab and Go Info. Sentiment analysis can be done with or without building a machine learning model. This tutorial will go over the Python implementation of TextBlob, VADER, and Flair for non-model sentiment analysis. After finishing the tutorial, you will learn: what is TextBlob? What is VADER? What is Flair? How to use Python library TextBlob for sentiment analysis? How to use Python library VADER for sentiment analysis? How to use Flair's pre-trained model in Python for sentiment analysis? Comparison between TextBlob versus VADER versus Flair. Let's get started. The first step is to install and import Python libraries. We need to install the VADER sentiment package for VADER and the Flair package for Flair. After installing the packages, let's import the Python libraries. We need to import pandas and numpy for data processing. For the sentiment analysis, we need to import TextBlob, sentiment intensity analyzer from VADER sentiment, and text classifier from Flair. We also need to load the English sentiment data from text classifier and import sentence for text processing for the Flair pre-trained model. To check the sentiment prediction accuracy, we need to import accuracy score from Sclearn. Last but not least, we set the pandas data frame column width to be 1000, which will allow us to see more content from the review. The second step is to download and read in the dataset. The UCI Machine Learning Repository has the review data from three websites: mdb.com, amazon.com, and yelp.com. We will use the review data from amazon.com for this tutorial. Please follow these steps to download the data. 1. Go to the UCI webpage for the sentiment-labeled sentences. 2. Click Data Folder. 3. Download sentiment-labeled sentences.zip. 4. Unzip sentiment-labeled sentences.zip. 5. Copy the file Amazon sells labeled.txt to your project folder. Those who are using Google Colab for this analysis need to mount Google Drive to read the dataset. You can ignore the code below if you are not using Google Colab. Now let's read the data into a pandas data frame and see what the dataset looks like. Info helps us to get the information about the dataset. From the output, we can see that this dataset has two columns, 1,000 records, and no missing data. The review column is object type, and the label column is int 64 type. Next, let's check the distribution of the label. There are 500 positive and 500 negative reviews in the dataset, so we have a balanced dataset. For a balanced dataset, we can use accuracy as the performance metric. If you are interested in imbalanced dataset classification, please check out my imbalance classification and anomaly detection tutorials. TextBlob is a Python library for natural language processing. Sentiment analysis is one of many NLP tasks that TextBlob supports. The sentiment property in TextBlob returns a polarity score and a subjectivity score for the input text. The polarity score ranges from minus 1 to 1, where minus 1 means extremely negative, and 1 means highly positive. A score near 0 means neutral sentiment. The subjectivity score ranges from 0 to 1, where 0 means extremely objective and 1 means highly subjective. In this example, the sample text grabandgoinfo.com is a great machine learning tutorial website, has a polarity score of 0.8 and the subjectivity score of 0.75, which means TextBlob interprets the sentence to have a subjective positive sentiment. We can use polarity to extract the sentiment score. VADER is a Python library focusing on social media sentiments. It has a built-in algorithm to change sentiment intensity based on punctuations, slang, emojis, and acronyms. The output of VADER includes four scores: compound score, negative score, neutral score, and positive score. The POS, new, and neg represent the percentage of tokens that fall into each category, so they add up together to be 100%. The compound score is a single score to measure the sentiment of the text. Similar to TextBlob, it ranges from minus 1 to 1. The scores near 0 represent the neural sentiment score. The compound score is not a simple aggregation of the POS, new, and neg scores. Instead, it incorporates rule-based enhancements such as punctuation amplifiers. VADER gave the sample text grabandgoinfo.com as a great machine learning tutorial website. Compound score of 0.6249. There is no negative word in the sentence, so the neg score value is 0. There are 63.1% of neutral words and 36.9% of positive words in the sentence. The output of VADER is saved as a dictionary. We can extract the compound sentiment score by the key compound. Flair is a state-of-art NLP framework built on PyTorch. It incorporates recent researches and provides an easy way to combine different embeddings to various NLP tasks. The pre-trained sentiment model offers a tool for sentiment analysis without training a customized model. Unlike TextBlob and VADER that output a sentiment score between minus 1 and 1, Flair sentiment output the predicted label with a confidence score. The confidence score ranges from 0 to 1, with 1 being very confident and 0 being very unconfident. Before predicting the sentiment of a text, the input text needs to be tokenized by sentence. After that, we can see the sample text was split into 9 tokens. Next, we use predict to predict the sentiment. The sample text grabandgoinfo.com is a great machine learning tutorial website, has the predicted sentiment of positive and the confidence score of 0.9895. Since 0.9895 is close to 1, Flair is very confident about the predictions. The predicted label is saved as value and the prediction confidence is saved as score. We can use sentence, labels, value and sentence, labels, score separately to extract the values. In step 6, we will apply TextBlob to the Amazon review dataset and see how it performs. We first get the sentiment polarity for each review and save the values into a column called scores TextBlob. Then check if the polarity score is positive. If the score is greater than or equal to 0, the predicted sentiment for the review is positive. Otherwise, the predicted sentiment for the review is negative. After getting predictions from TextBlob, let's check the prediction accuracy. Comparing the actual label with the TextBlob prediction, we get an accuracy score of 0.688, which means that TextBlob predicted the review sentiment 68.8% of the time. In step 7, we will apply VADER to the Amazon review dataset and see how it performs. We first get the sentiment compound score for each review and save the values into a column called scores VADER. Then check if the compound score is positive. If the score is greater than or equal to 0, the predicted sentiment for the review is positive. Otherwise, the predicted sentiment for the review is negative. After getting predictions from VADER, let's check the prediction accuracy. Comparing the actual label with the VADER prediction, we get an accuracy score of 0.768, which means that VADER predicted the review sentiment 76.8% of the time. TextBlob has a prediction accuracy of 68.8% for the same dataset. So VADER has an 8% improvement over the TextBlob prediction. In step 8, we will apply the Flair pre-trained sentiment model to predict the sentiment of the Amazon reviews. Firstly, let's define a function that takes a review as input and the predicted label and confidence as outputs. Then apply the function to each review in the dataset. We can see that the summary statistics show that most Flair scores are close to 1, which means that the Flair sentiment model is overall very confident about the predictions. The distribution of the labels is very balanced. Before checking the prediction accuracy, we need to map the negative value to 0 and the positive value to 1 because the Amazon review dataset has true labels of 0 and 1. After comparing the Flair prediction with the actual sentiment label, we can see that Flair predicts the sentiment correctly 94.8% of the time. The prediction accuracy is an 18% increase from VADER and a 26% increase from TextBlob. In this tutorial, we compared TextBlob versus VADER versus Flair for sentiment analysis. In terms of methodology, VADER and TextBlob are lexicon and rule-based. Flair is model-based. For the meaning of the scores, VADER and TextBlob have sentiment scores ranging from minus 1 to 1, where minus 1 means very negative, 1 means very positive, and 0 means neutral. Flair has a score ranging from 0 to 1, where 0 means very unconfident about the prediction and 1 means very confident about the prediction. If we compare the speed, Flair is slower than TextBlob and VADER because the computation algorithm is more complicated. About accuracy. Based on the results of this project, Flair has the best prediction accuracy. VADER is the second best, and TextBlob is the third. After reading the article, you have learned. What is TextBlob? What is VADER? What is Flair? How to use Python library TextBlob for sentiment analysis. How to use Python library VADER for sentiment analysis. How to use Flair pre-trained model in Python for sentiment analysis. Comparison between TextBlob versus VADER versus Flair. If you are interested in the nuanced differences between TextBlob and VADER, please refer to my article TextBlob versus VADER for sentiment analysis using Python. If you found the information in this tutorial helpful, please click the like button and subscribe to the channel. I publish tutorials on machine learning, deep learning, and big data processing every week. If you prefer the written version of the tutorial, please go to grabandgoinfo.com. I will put the link in the video description. This is the blog post for this tutorial. It has all the code and explanations in the video. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video.